गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन. सो टुडे इज़ 25 मई 2020 एंड इंडिया हैज़ रजिस्टर्ड हाइएस्ट नंबर ऑफ सिंगल डे राइज स्पाइक इन COVID-19 केसेज विथ 7,097 न्यू केसेज. इंडिया इज़ नाउ इन द टॉप 10 कंट्रीज विद द मोस्ट नंबर ऑफ COVID-19 केसेज. कमिंग टू द फर्स्ट आर्टिकल फॉर फार्म्स एंड फार्मर्स. सो हियर द एडिटर इज़ टॉकिंग अबाउट the schemes and the policies which the central government as well as the state governments are bringing up to uplift our farmers, and at the same time he's talking about what more has to be done to actually uplift the farmers' position. So here the editor has taken a stance on Rajiv Gandhi Kisan Nyay Yojana, which has been launched by Chhattisgarh last week, and it aims to supplement the income of the state's 18 lakh rice, maize and sugarcane farmers by through direct cash transfer of 10,000 to 13,000 per acre. So at the same time, center also provide cash transfer to farmers who have less than 5 acres of land. So center provides 6,000 rupees per year. Then other states like Telangana, Odisha and Andhra Pradesh, they also have income support scheme for farmers. And along with that, in Government of India has also minimum support price regime, which works in the combination with public distribution system. So MSP and PDS is also there. So MSP is the minimum support price which the government fixes, Ministry of Economic Affairs fixes on the recommendation of CACP. And PDS is the public distribution system, but it has been seen in the in times that center fixes MSP at 1.5 times the cost of production, but this calculation has been in controversy for many times. Even last year, the states ruled by BJP like UP and Haryana have questioned the MSP miscalculations. So there are many income support schemes like what is happening in Chhattisgarh now and Telangana, Odisha and Andhra Pradesh, and also the center is providing. But the thing here is the editor here is talking about that these interventions are only palliative and cannot address the underlying problem. So underlying problem, according to editor, is that we do not have proper supply chain mechanism, because of which the remuneration which a farmer gets on his production, like he is producing rice or wheat or maize or something, and he is putting a lot of efforts, manual efforts, and lot of capital also, land, labor, fertilizer, irrigation, water, and seeds. But he is not getting that proper remuneration, and because somewhere India lacks in supply chain mechanism, we do not have proper storage facilities or logistic facilities, because of which in the end the farmers suffer. Along with that, we have to also learn from this pandemic. The US, which has a very efficient supply chain mechanism, has ended up with wasted produce and unmet demand. So it's not only important to develop a supply chain mechanism, but also to learn from the vulnerabilities and problems which has been faced by many countries, and reduce the wastage as much as we can. So the editor here, in the later paragraph, he says that the income support scheme is good, but it should be supplemented by educating the farmers about the vulnerability of cropping, about the proper sustainable crop patterns, in adequate irrigation, adoption of technology, and these should be done, because in the end these things will increase their production, and because of which the mission of doubling the farmers' income would be reached. So the creation of a buoyant agriculture sector will take much more, and these efforts must be made on a war footing, because the farmers, which are the food provider of a country, are actually at the lowest strata of the economic cycle. So for their upliftment, we have to work on a war footing. We have to develop our infrastructure, increase our supply chain mechanism, make it efficient. The second article is the danger in the air. So this article is on the PIA crash. So you might be knowing that Pakistan International Airlines flight, which was scheduled to land at Jinnah International Airport at Karachi, it crashed into a residential area with 91 passengers and 8 crew on board. This airline was operated by Airbus A320-214, and this is considered as one of aviation's reliable and modern workhorses. So the actual reason of the crash would be revealed only when the information in the black box would be revealed. But experts are suggesting that the plane crashed because maybe the engines failed, and because of which the plane crashed. So the air safety commentators points in a relevant direction. So authorities in Pakistan and PIA, an established flag carrier, have detailed the plane's technical flight and maintenance history, which the operator's history, it is not having a very good air safety record. So there is also another core and related issue related to this. Due to the COVID-19 pandemic, which has scorched commercial airline operations and balance sheets, the airline managers are keen to operate their flights, and due to which the precautionary steps which should be taken before getting the flights on board is somewhere they can afford to overlook them, like complete maintenance check, air crew being allowed at the controls only after key proficiency check, and so these regulations can be overlooked by these regulators, and because of which and also there is no margin of error in aviation sector. So if any regulator is overlooking this thing, then it might cause another such tragic accident. So this tragedy has highlighted one more issue, one more point, that is the overcrowding and densely populated areas near the airports, that what has been seen in the Karachi case. So Indian authorities also, the aviation authorities also, they have often glossed over high court or orders to order demolish structure around aerodromes. So they say that the guidelines which have been issued by International Civil Aviation Organization should be followed strictly. So in the end, to perorate, I can say that these guidelines should be followed strictly, and due hearing should be given to Indian aviation authorities for the development and upliftment of aviation sector in India. So that's all for today. Thank you, and have a good day.